Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Today we're looking at the top 10 power forwards in the NBA. Possibly the weakest position in the NBA, continuing my top 10 series from each position. Gotta have some honorable mentions. The first honorable mention is LaMarcus Aldridge, who would be top 10 but is getting older and is one of the only players who plays in the post. Larry Markkanen is a bit too young, but his three-point game is incredible. And then you got Julius Randle, who probably will be on the top 10 list sometime this season, as he's playing like a superstar, but he wasn't comfortable putting him on the top 10 list yet. At number 10, we have Paul Millsap. This bro is getting really old, but what he does bring you is veteran leadership and explosiveness. And he also brings sometimes can play center, as he goes for jump balls a lot. Is very, very, very inclusive for his teammates, as he likes to pass the ball. And he likes to go for layups and tries not to make many mistakes. At number 9, we have Montrezl Harrell, sixth man of the Los Angeles Lakers, and he has a big chance to win sixth man of the year. Regardless, the power forward is amazing. At a strong 6'8", he has the ability to bully people in the post, get in people's way, and go to the basket for layups, but he can also shoot the jumper from 10-15 feet, and I love his dunking ability. Watching him dunk the ball at 6'8", 250 pounds, is so fun to watch. At number 8, Danilo Gallinari. You can say what you want about this dude, and you can say he's getting older, but with the Atlanta Hawks, he's going to be a key piece this year. Although he is injured and hasn't played a game yet for them, I think he'll be a key contributor for Atlanta, as I see him putting up a stat line this year of something like 15 points, 7 rebounds, and 2 assists, and something like 45% from the field and 48% from 3, which is what he's always been, the best 3-point shooter of the power forward position. At number 7, we have Jaren Jackson Jr. Now, Jackson is another power forward who is coming off of an injury. But when he is healthy, he's probably the best shooter at the power forward position in the NBA. Sure, his jump shot does look a bit weird, but, I mean, it works. His post game and three-point shooting are probably his best assets, and his field goal percentage is very, very high on great efficiency. At number 6, we have Kevin Love, forward of the Cleveland Cavaliers. Look, the Cleveland Cavaliers are maybe going to make the playoffs this year. But with Love injured, another power forward injured, I don't know if they'll be able to produce as well. But when Love is healthy, you've got to admit, he's the best rebounder in the NBA. And if he hadn't left Minnesota, maybe he could have been the best rebounder of all time. Who knows? He only played 6 seasons with Minnesota in his career. At number 5, Blake Griffin. The dude is 31 years old, getting older, and is injury prone. But his best seasons came usually in his first few years in the NBA. But you gotta admit, he's one of the best power forwards in the NBA still. And, I mean, I had to rank him here because, well, there aren't a lot of great power forwards in the NBA right now. So, it's hard to rank him any lower. At number 4, Christian Wood. Christian Wood is a stud, and he looks like an absolute star. This year, he is putting up 24 points per game. And if he keeps this up, I could see him being the star of the Houston Rockets next year if things turn out the way I think they will with a James Harden trade. This boy might be the future of the Houston Rockets. which I know is crazy, but look, it's amazing. At number three, we have Zion Williamson, forward of the New Orleans Pelicans. Zion is a beast. At 6'8", 270 pounds, Zion has the athletic ability of a guard and the wingspan of a center, able to dunk the ball from the free throw line, which is probably his best asset in the game. His finishing ability and shooting ability are also things that I think will help with his game, and he might have a little bit of a three-point shot if you watch the game. Then number two is Kristaps Porzingis. Dude, this bro is 7'3" and he's considered a power forward, and the reason why is because he shoots threes from the logo. And the reason he's not a center is because what center shoots threes from the logo? This proved that Kristaps Porzingis is such a unicorn. With his nice post ability, like all power forwards, and his three-point ability, it looks like he might be able to become one of the next superstar generational type players in today's NBA. He's the perfect player for that. And at number one, this was expected, Anthony Davis. You all expected Davis to be number one, and Davis is a unicorn, just like Porzingis. His three-point ability was insane in the playoffs last year, and if he's able to keep that up, I think he has a huge chance to win MVP this year. Regardless, his post-game, like all power forwards, like I keep saying, and his floater ability is awesome. He also has the skill to catch lobs from LeBron and lead the Lakers to a championship this year. Anyway, thanks for watching. Click subscribe, turn notifications on, like, share, comment, all that good stuff. And as always, I'll see you guys next time. Peace out.